Hi everyone, my name is Vicent and I'm going to present the following work called Application of Robust Design Optimization in a Continuous Box-Girder Pedestrian Bridge, in which I will explain what is the robust design optimization and I will show two examples where it could be applied in the construction field. For this, I will follow the index shown in this slide. First, I will make an introduction about what is the robust design optimization. Then, I will show the methodology used in this work, followed by the description of the case of study and the results and the final conclusions. The robust design optimization is a methodology that allows to obtain those solutions that, besides being optimal, are not very sensitive to the variation of some uncertain initial parameter or variable, as can be the structural uncertainties or the variability of the different point of views of the decision makers in the decision-making problems. In order to study this initial variation, it's necessary to move from the deterministic approach of the problem to a probabilistic approach. Therefore, if we want to obtain an optimal design of a structure in the traditional way for a defined objecting function, we use some initial deterministic parameters and therefore we reach a single optimal design. This optimal design will be the best under the initial conditions. However, a small variation of one of these initial variables can cause a large variation in the objecting function, and can cause that the optimal design goes into a non-feasible area too. In contrast, in probabilistic optimization, the initial parameter or variable used to study its influence on the objecting function becomes a probabilistic value. In this way, a set of optimizations are made by varying the initial uncertain parameter or variable, so that it can be observed how the objecting function varies according to the variability of this parameter or variable. Thus, for each design, the mean and the standard deviation of the objecting function can be obtained and different solutions can be chosen. The most optimal design, which will correspond to the traditional optimization and will be the one with the lowest mean, that is the solution A. The most robust design, which will be defined by a low variation of the objecting function, which will correspond to the solution B. And an intermediate solution, which will correspond to the robust optimal design, that it's the design that we are looking for, and it will be the solution C. The main problem of probabilistic optimization and robust design optimization is that for each iteration of the optimization, a large number of calculations have to be carried out to obtain the variability of the objecting function, which implies a large computational cost. One of the ways to solve this problem is by the use of meta-models, since from an initial sample of designs, it allows to create a mathematical approximation whereby introducing to a set of parameters and initial variables, the objecting function can be predicted, saving a lot of computational cost. In this work, the Latin hypercube sampling is used for the creation of the initial sample, since it allows to cover all the design space. The Green meta-model is used for the build of the mathematical approximation, since it allows to take into account both a global and local vision of the information. And finally, the algorithm of simulated annealing has been used for the optimization. However, we must remember that the robust design optimization is a probabilistic approach where the variability of some initial parameters are studied. Therefore, each design of the initial sample will not have a single value of the objecting function, but a set of values that converts the green surface into a volume with a variable thickness. In this slide, we can see a general view of the methodology used in this work. Once the objecting function, the assigned variables and the constraints are defined, an initial population is generated by means of the Latin hypercube sampling. Later, for each one of these points of the initial sample, the objecting function is calculated varying the initial study parameter, and therefore obtaining the mean and the standard deviation. Then a green surface is generated for the mean and the standard deviation, and finally a set of optimal designs has been obtained by varying the weights of thus obtaining a Pareto frontier. The structure used in this work is a post-tension pedestrian bridge with three spans of 40, 50 and 40 meters with a concrete box-girder section. The design variables considered are 7 geometric variables and the concrete strengths. Once a design is defined, both the post-tension steel and the reinforcing steel required to accomplish the limit states are obtained. As an example, two case studies are made on this structure. The first case of a study represents the possible uncertainties on parameters that are defined for the structural calculation. In this case, we are looking for the bridge with the lowest cost and the best structural behavior varying the self-weight. The second case of a study represents the variability in the decision-making problems. In this case, the aim is to obtain the most sustainable design when faced with economic, environmental, and social criteria, whose importance can vary depending on the point of view of each decision-maker, represented by the relative weights. In the first case, that corresponds to the structural uncertainty, the aim was to find the bridge with the best cost and the best structural stability. The best cost is represented by the lowest mean cost, while the highest structural stability is represented by the lowest standard deviation of the vertical displacement. After carrying out a large number of optimization varying the relative weight, a set of optimal solutions that represent the Pareto front is obtained. In this Pareto front, we can obtain the solution with the lowest cost, which corresponds to the solution obtained through traditional optimization, that is the number one. The most robust solution, that corresponds to the solution with the best structural stability, that is the number 3, and the solution between both, the number 2, that will be the optimal robust solution. We can see that the most important variables are the depth of the bridge and the concrete strength, since the other remains practically the same. In the second case, that represents the variability in the decision-making problems, we want to look for the bridge design that is sustainable regardless of the decision-maker's point of view. This is achieved by obtaining a solution that optimizes both the mean and the standard deviation of the sustainability index. Carrying out the robust design optimization, in this example we obtain a solution that is sustainable regardless of the point of view of the decision makers, which is interesting since it would allow us to avoid the subjective part that these decision makers provide. Finally, some conclusions are obtained. First, the methodology proposed provides optimal solutions that are low sensitive to the external variation. In the case 1, structural variability, this methodology provides solutions with lowest cost, best structural behavior, or both simultaneously. In the case 2, decision-making variability, this methodology allows to obtain optimal solutions regardless the life cycle sustainability criteria and robust with respect to the stakeholders' opinions. Finally, the grading-based optimizations make it possible to obtain robust optimum design. In all cases, a robust design involves an increment of two specific design variables, depths and concrete strengths. Thank you for your attention.